being black, but also being a homosexual, because this is my opinion based on the scripture of the Word of God. It is a choice. Biologically, God has created us male or female. I don't care how you look at it. You can change it if you want to, but this is the way that it is. And I believe that the first question is this.
Please.
The first question is, this is why we're in the position we're in now. But the first question, this first question you ask, the laws are already in place for discrimination against food, housing, and jobs. So why are we even here anyway?
Amen.
So what would be the difference?
And second piece of her question.
Say what?
And your second question was,
if the majority of the citizens of Jacksonville were vocally not in favor of the HRO, but you think it's the right thing, do you think we ought to do what the majority says, or what's the right thing to do when it comes to discrimination?
I believe that it's already law in effect now. To cover all of this for anybody, there's already anti-discrimination law, the EEOC. We already have the laws in place now, so what is the difference? That means there's a law that's going to supersede the law that you already have now for discrimination. Everyone is covered under discrimination. So what is that?
All right, thank you. Hold on. I appreciate it. Finish your statement, then I'll move on.
That was the conclusion of the statement. I mean, we already have these laws in place now.
Thank you.
School, job, employment, you can go in any restaurant, you can be hired in any business, you can have any housing where that you want. The laws are there, even with the KKK. There's laws against this already, so why do we need another law to supersede that law?
I'm going to allow Reverend Daly to speak in just a minute, but I'm going to ask Michael Smith if you